I set it for recording mode as well. I think some of you may not have attended session yesterday because of some kind of work, but now most of you might have gone through this recorded session, as well as most of you attended the session yesterday session and might have taken care of installing prerequisite softwares and environment for making simple Hello World like a program. Am I right? Yes, great, no?
Yes, sir.
Good. I think you might have gone through this particular video, correct? No, definitely, I'm going to set the agenda for my today's session. Today's agenda has been already conveyed to you, correct? No. So today's agenda will be focusing on, let me say, this is our day two going on. And under this day two, our focus is actually now getting into the world of programming, correct? No. So we are going to touch programming world. This programming world we are going to explore by using a language. That language is called C# language. Correct, no? Which is nothing but, I could say, like an official language of .NET. Correct, no? You can use VB.NET language. You can use F# language. There are more than 25 languages which have supported. Correct, no? This compliance for getting tuned for .NET environment. But whenever someone really works on Microsoft .NET technology, so the favorite language always called C# language, correct? No? Yes? Fantastic. So this is the C# language we are using for our application development. Okay, we always represent C# like this syntax. This syntax C#, we are going to focus on this area. So C# language, what we're going to start with this area. We'll be talking about something called solution. How to build your solution. Okay, so building solution. Building solution, then focusing on artifacts of programming. We'll be focusing on something called natural way of thinking. Okay, we are going to come across under this natural of thinking, something called as nothing but object orientation. We are going to focus on something area, which is nothing but like a develop application, like a service, something people use word called SOA, service oriented architecture. So these are the major points, which actually today we are going to have it for in our today's session. Definitely that everything will be started from the scratch, but I'm just taking you the word. It's a programming world we are going to get for this thing. Okay, but before getting with this day one activity, I hope you remember the kind of points which you discuss in your day one. Anybody remember? Slightly recap of our yesterday's topic. Yesterday, I think we started with introduction, correct? No? Yes, I think Rohit introduced himself, Umesh introduced himself, Mayuresh introduced himself, correct? No? At the same time, Vishwambar also introduced. There are other students also about to get themselves to be introduced, correct? No? We are very happy to see such a crowd. Almost we are having 14 participants for your about to join, correct? No? Introduction, then what is the next thing we discuss after the introduction, if you remember? .NET, correct? No? .NET core. I think we discussed about the course agenda, correct? No? We talked about .NET core. We talked about full stack application. I hope you remember somewhere we also talked about applications of different types. For example, we talked about something called desktop application. We also talked about something called distributed application. These applications has been built for a particular organization where different people with different roles belonging to different area line of business are working together for doing some kind of work, correct? No? So we also call such kind of applications which are used for organization. I think these applications are called enterprise applications, correct? No? When you talk about enterprise applications, these enterprise applications has been used by a number of people. So we always find these distributed applications are totally based on a concept. That concept is actually what we call as client server applications. And these applications which are based on client server model, we actually call client server model, no? Client server model, correct, no? So that differentiate your desktop application. So remember the desktop application, the word which we used last time. Can somebody just give me the hint? What's that word we use for that desktop application? Anybody
standalone.
remember? Pardon?
Standalone no.
Very good. Standalone application. Correct? No? Standalone application. So how to differentiate your standard application from your distributed applications? Everything is kept on one machine, the whole executable, its libraries, its data, its functionality, its front end, its back end, everything is kept on one machine running for only one user. We call that application desktop application. Can you just think about, can I use this desktop application nothing but single user application? What do you think? Today I added some new thing. Whenever called desktop application, it's a single user interface application. But when you talk about distributed applications, so during that time, we find that this distributed application is going to be accessed by multiple client. And the application's core is kept at the centralized place. So we will always try to see your distributed application will have two. Okay, two. Application components, no? See, I'm trying to revise. I'm trying to add something new here. So two application components are there. I think one is called as a client application. Okay, no? Client application. Application, sorry. And second is called as a server application.
Server application.
Very good. Fantastic. So client application. So we have got concept. Okay, there might be certain application which is used by single user. So single user interface would have been given for this client application. So this client application can be some desktop application.
Yes.
Correct, no? Or this application may not be desktop application because your client might be using certain something called device, gadget. So that device, something called smartphone. And we will have something called mobile app. So you might use mobile application. And this mobile application, which will help us to get connected to the actual core application, which is kept at the centralized place. Okay, no? So your application, which you call distributed application, this distributed application is actually is going to be given in the form of like a client app and server app. Client app, which is supposed to be installed on every particular user's machine. And this particular client application will help us to get connected. I use word here, client app. Get connected, okay, to centralized app. Centralized app, okay, hosted in internet. Or you can also call hosted on web. Or you can call hosted on internet, on web, or might be called as in cloud. Correct, no? So don't you think this internet word, this web word, and this cloud words are same? Am I right, no? And now we find that this application can be connected by your client application or anywhere in the world. So what is the most important thing required? This particular centralized application, which you call as a server application, getting connected. So we really require here something called connectivity. Correct, no?
Yes.
So connectivity. Connectivity. Bandwidth. Correct, no? Physical connectivity, logical connectivity, you can call link. Correct, no? You could call protocol. You could call, can somebody add the word? I think that is what we call here, the connectivity, which is nothing but the bandwidth. The bandwidth you always get by using something called fiber optics cable, LAN cable. You might use Wi-Fi, okay, no? And you get connected to the world. You get connected to the world means you get connected to the internet. And then this is the way your gadgets are getting connected to your internet. And on this internet, okay, no? There are so many companies have deployed their own applications, which are centralized applications. So we also call that applications as nothing but something called as web applications, correct, no? Web applications. So these web applications, why they are web applications? Because they're deployed to web. And since they're deployed to the web, they are, okay, using web protocol. So these applications are getting connected by any particular client application, correct? No? Protocol. This web protocol, we actually call one particular protocol. What is that protocol? Anybody remember? Any particular HTTP. Web application, you always type http://. Am I right? No? www.google.com. Sabka Malik, correct? No? Jo bhi chahiye, you can always get through Google, correct? No? So Google, it is a one kind of web request you make and you get a Google page. And Google page, you can search for anything. You can search for Ravi Tambre, you can search for Rohit, you can search for Shubham. And you'll get Ravi Tambre's LinkedIn ID, or you may get Shubham's LinkedIn ID or Facebook ID, might be his YouTube channel. You get all information from this simple one particular web application, which we call is nothing but web search
engine.
Very good. Oh, that means now we come across one word, no? What is this? All right, web application. It is word www.google.com. This www.google.com, it is some kind of like a unique identifier to know this web application. So we use word called URL, no? Universal Resource Locator, a unique. Unique name for each web application. So this web application right now, which we're accessing, it's what kind of application? www.google.com. It is a web search engine, but someone can go back and type here one word here, http://www.youtube.com. Am I right? So what is YouTube? Is it a web search engine, my dear friend? Tell me. Yes, Shubham?
No.
Can I use, this is something called a content management.
I think it is a multiple things here. Like also they have the search engine also. And like streaming engine also might be there.
Very good. Streaming, and you can call it. Very good. I think you also wanted to point it out, sir. This is something YouTube. What is YouTube actually? If you just look around, even if I just go it's back and try to use
web application.
Web, you know, ये तो पता चला कि web application है कि नहीं? आज का हमारा topic है उसके बारे web application. अगर मैंने यहाँ पे जाके लिख दिया YouTube, तो YouTube करने के बाद में, this is the kind of YouTube. www.youtube.com. Correct? No, it's a web application. So with the help of this web application, you can enjoy video, music you love and upload original content and share with all friends. Have you read this simple sentence? I think that statement tells you something very important point. Okay, please try to unmute your microphone so that that will not create problem for us. Good. So you feel like YouTube is what? It is something called where you can enjoy video and music, no? Ultimately, what did you say? YouTube, it is a kind of web application. That web application allows us to watch videos, am I right? As well as you can also listen very good kind of music, audio. So can I use the word that is something called, it is a kind of web application where you have got digital multimedia content. Can you accept my this word, my dear friend? Tell me. Yes. You can always prompt me on chat window. Correct? No? One of the most important thing in a virtual classroom, you need to be much more like a responsive. Not responsible. Responsive means interactive. And this interactive, we will try to use the chat window. So chat window can the yes, thumb, aapko pata hai. Aap WhatsApp pe sare use karte na. Like, dislike, your happy face like that way. You know, the chat window is available in this particular Zoom meeting. That will help me to get your expressions, correct? No? Yeah, digital multimedia content library, correct? No? Lekin aapko pata hai, if you just go back and access, main web application ki baat kar raha hu. If I just click this one, I really find www.youtube.com site. Whenever I just get in this thing, I really find there are so many kind of good YouTube video which Ravi likes to watch has been given here. So it's a kind of like a video library. Am I right? Yes, it is a video library. Fantastic, this video library, you can really have it here. So you cannot only watch good videos. You cannot only watch very good videos, but at the same time, have you seen something? You see here, start option. Oh, this YouTube application help us for end user. So can somebody access this YouTube? Anybody can access this YouTube. So anybody who can access web YouTube. So can I say this is the kind of web application which you talk about, a web application. Anybody can access. So anybody can access such kind of web application. What do you call? Public website. Am I right? So such kind of website, we also call this application is nothing but as internet application. Am I right? Internet application. Anybody can access, public access. But the way the word is come as an internet application, we also has got one more word here. Intranet application. Have you observed the word? Internet. Internet means anybody can go by and access. But sometimes this internet application also can be accessed by any user. Any user or okay, you also give the access by secure user with more functionality. My focus is on applications. My focus is on C sharp language understanding. But before that, I'm just trying to create one environment. You know? So it's an internet application. You also call it a public app. If it's a public app, anybody can access. Anybody can access, that means we call as anonymous user access. Okay, no? You don't require credentials to access that application. But if you want to go back on this YouTube and on that YouTube, you can only watch videos, but at the same time, you also wanted to upload your own videos. Can anybody will be allowed to upload the videos on YouTube? Can somebody tell me? Yes? Yeah, YouTube is a web application. अभी मैं यूज कर रहा हूँ इस वेब एप्लीकेशन को तो शायद आई कैन ओनली सी द वेब एप्लीकेशंस गोइंग टू शो मी समथिंग कॉल्ड मल्टीपल यूट्यूब वीडियोस एंड आई कैन रियली फाइंड दोस वीडियोस आई कैन वॉच दिस वीडियोस आई कैन एंजॉय दिस म्यूजिक लेकिन अभी मुझे लगा कि रवि मुझे अपना एक वीडियो अपलोड करना है सो दैट दिस वीडियो कैन बी सीन बाई ऑल स्टूडेंट्स ऑल माई फ्रेंड्स ऑल माई कलीग्स तो नहीं आपको लगता कि एनीबडी इफ दे ट्राई टू अपलोड दिस वीडियो देर आर गोइंग टू बी द चांसेस आई थिंक वेरी रॉन्ग वीडियोज will be uploaded on this YouTube and that will create a problem in a society. So we wanted only trusted users. Kya bola maine? See? Trusted users will be allowed to upload digital content. Can I use the word digital content now? आज का टॉपिक जो है हम उसी को लेके जा रहे हैं ट्रस्टेड यूजर्स विल बी अलाउड टू अपलोड डिजिटल कंटेंट नाउ दिस डिजिटल कंटेंट कुड बी वीडियो सो व्हेन यू वांट अ ट्रस्टेड दैट मींस यू रियली वांटेड ओनली रजिस्टर्ड यूजर्स हैव गॉट एक्सेस फॉर सच थिंग्स एम आई राइट नो So if you just look around this YouTube application and you really find when I just get that YouTube application, have you seen something shown here? If I try to access YouTube, I really find this YouTube application has been accessed by using ravitambade.transfer.in. Oh, that means Ravi Tambade has logged in to this YouTube channel. Now I use what? This is what we call YouTube channel. Okay, no? Ravi Tambade. @transfer.in. He has logged into this web application using Google account. And if he is logged in to the YouTube account like this way, now he can really come across and he can really find some kind of option where he's got an option called library. Can you find the library option? And when you click the library, you really find someone's video. You really want to watch it at the same time. And at the same time, you also find Ravi Tambade also has his own kind of YouTube playlist. And where you really find this one thing you call mentoring. So it's a Ravi Tambade created his own kind of like a library. And under that library, I really find inside this area, we have got a very good kind of videos available. So these videos has been uploaded. 26, 2020. Okay, let us not see the video. You can see after some time, but this video was uploaded somewhere on 26th, 2020. I think definitely 1 year back, this video was uploaded. Okay, video has been watched by some people. You also get the analytics. Ki, I like to see when this video was watched, how this video is like. You really get analytics like a sampling data and tells me how many people have subscribed, what is the average watch time for that. I really see very good kind of analysis. Correct, no? Trending. I can really go back and I see that particular thing. Engagement, reach, audience. आपको नहीं लग रहा है ये जो फीचर्स अभी आप देख रहे हो वेब एप्लीकेशन का, दिस फीचर्स आर ओनली अवेलेबल फॉर द पर्सन हु इज ओनली लॉग इन, हु कैन बी अ ट्रस्टेड यूजर. ही कैन ओनली गो बैक एंड वॉच हिज वीडियो, ही कैन कंटेंट दैट वीडियो, ही कैन सी द ट्राफिक ऑफ दैट कंटेंट व्हिच इज प्रमोटेड एंड ही कैन जस्ट गेट ऑल दोस थिंग इटसेल्फ. यू नो, ग्रेट. कैन आई जस्ट गो बैक अंडर दिस एरिया एंड ट्राई टू सिलेक्ट सम ऑप्शन हियर कॉल क्रिएट. So now this YouTube website also allows me, because I logged in as a Ravi Tambre and click on the option called create. And when I select the clicked option, I got option called upload the video. So when I select upload the video, you really find now it'll ask me one thing. Would you like to upload the video file? Now I can really go back and select option. I really want to upload certain video. I really go back and try to find my folder where I have got certain videos which I like to share with all of you. So might be somewhere in Transflower. Might be somewhere in Transflower has got my folder, local machine folder, got TFL edit videos, and where I can find, I have got a lot of videos. I kept it here from my motivational perspective, from my online learning perspective, or so kind of things. So might be I'm interested to share some kind of my Linux videos with someone. So whatever Linux related sessions I would have conducted, I think those videos, I can just take it and I can just upload it here. See? What I'm trying to tell you about application. This application where you give the information, you click the button next, and your YouTube video will be available on this particular channel. So can I say this particular YouTube, it is a kind of web application where Ravi Tambre can have his own channel, and under that channel, Ravi Tambre can keep uploading his own videos, and he can also check these videos will be accessed by everyone or whether the video will be accessed only by the person who has given permission. When this video was uploaded, okay, how many people have viewed the videos? How many likes were there for that video? I think this gives me information ki whether my content which I'm creating for students are really beneficial or not. How many people are watching my videos? So it's give me very good kind of personalized channel management. Correct, no? So shayad aapne yahan pe dekha hoga, ye google.com kya tha? Search engine tha. And what is this YouTube now? Multimedia library? No. It is actually called as WCM. Application. क्या वर्ड यूज किया मैंने यहाँ पे? Have you come across the word? शायद किसी को इसका फुल फॉर्म पता है? रोहित, have you come across this particular full form WCM?
Web content management kind of.
Very good, fantastic. Actually, it is called as web content management. Okay, the word is called web content management. So this is the kind of web application. Where under the web application, we will manage our content. So our content can be page, our content can be image, our content can be video, our content can be, can I just put here properly? Content can be document, our content can be page, image, document. Someone can think about? Can you guess? Okay, web content management. Web content hota kya hai? Web page hota hai, image hota hai, video or document or something might be there. Anything which you think about?
Some extra information related to that particular video or...
Oh, that means these are your actual content. Very good. Ye actually aapka content hai, ki nahi? Ye actually aapka content hai. Actual content. लेकिन एक्चुअल कंटेंट हम वीडियो तो अपलोड करेंगे, लेकिन वीडियो के साथ में हु हैज क्रिएटेड वीडियो, दिस वीडियोस फॉर होम, यू नो, एंड दिस वीडियो इज एक्चुअली हैविंग लाइक्स और नॉट. आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल व्हाट. सो कैन आई से दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्चुअल कंटेंट इज नथिंग बट अ डेटा, करेक्ट नो, एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट दैट डेटा. यू नो व्हाट इज दैट वर्ड वी यूज इन अवर कॉलेजेस इन योर एजुकेशन?
मेटा डेटा
है कि नहीं? तो मेटा डेटा के अंदर हो क्या सकता है? मींस इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट समथिंग, दैट मींस व्हाट इज द टाइटल ऑफ दिस वीडियो, व्हाट इज द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दैट वीडियो, यू नो,
देन क्रिएटेड,
यू आल्सो हु क्रिएटेड, क्रिएटेड बाय, अगेन कैन यू गेस,
वॉच
व्हेन दिस वीडियो इज पब्लिश्ड, करेक्ट नो,
या
कैन समबडी ऐड,
हाउ मेनी लाइक्स
आर देयर,
कमेंट्स.
Oh, very good. That means you also wanted to have something called like a comments. Correct, no? Okay. Or you also have something for that comments, might be something called reply. Are you getting, no?
Viewers.
And viewers, that means you would like to have a lot of social data, correct? No, and plus this data. So this data actually I call as a metadata, correct? No, so this metadata will be associated with each and every page, or might be with each and every image, or might be with each and every video. So yeah, data and metadata. Data plus metadata has been managed as a web content, and this content has been managed, you can access from any particular client application from your mobile phone or from this thing. So ye bhi ek prakar ka application ban gaya na. So abhi tak to humne itne hi baat, means we were only talking about ki web applications or websites. No, web applications are websites, but this website has got some common purpose: search engine, web content management. Am I right? Or someone try to access another kind of application. What is another kind of application you can just access? Anybody can tell me? The most important web application of this world, which is having millions of users connected, and they are using this application day and night, and that is the world's number one website, which is having high traffic. Anybody know what is that application?
Facebook.
Very good. www.facebook.com site. Correct? No. Yes. No. Yeah. So what we call this? It is a web application. Again, my answer. What is this? It is a web application. Yeah, it is a web application. But this web application has got what kind of role? So you say, sir, Ravi sir, it is nothing but social. What is that word you use? Am I right? But someone use word, sir, it is nothing but social networking. What is the word I use now at this moment? Have you checked it? मैंने कौन सा word use किया अभी? यहाँ पे word use किया मैंने web application. Here I use word network social website. And now what is the word I use here? Social networking. Can I use the word here? Web portal. Why I use the word web portal? Can somebody guess? Can you just go back and try to access here web? www.facebook.com site. So when I access this www.facebook.com site, have you observed facebook.com site? But this Facebook site is only been accessed by those people who are member of that site. Am I right? No. Let us do one thing right now. Ravi Tambre has logged into the Facebook. That is why Ravi Tambre can see his all friends informations like that way. But if I just do one thing, if I just go back and try to select this option and select the option here, something called logout. I log out from this website, and if I log out from the website, Ravi Tambre, please go back and do one more small thing. Please access Facebook, www.facebook.com. What happened, my dear friend? Can you see the content of the Facebook? No, you cannot see the content of the Facebook. Why? Because this Facebook is only for those people who are member of that Facebook site. It's a social networking kind of application, where people will get connected, people will become a member, they will create their own account, they will become a member of this Facebook site, and after becoming member of that Facebook site, I think they will be able to see their own kind of friends content, their announcements, as well as this thing, you know. But what about the www.youtube.com site? I think you do one thing, you just log out from this particular Facebook, but still you will be able to see your Facebook site. So I will always use the word, sorry, a YouTube site. YouTube gives me public access as well as my member site access. But here, Facebook, it is nothing but a portal. So portal. What is portal? Can you just think about portal? Web portal. Something is available on the web which can be only accessed by members. So portal means for only members. Am I right? If I really go back and try to use my browser, and under that browser, if I just type the word portal, portal meaning, I don't know what is portal meaning. Okay. I'm very curious to know about that portal. So can I just type portal? Internet ka pravesh kar karne wali website. ठीक है, दैट्स अ वेबसाइट दैट इज यूज एज अ पॉइंट ऑफ एंट्री टू द इंटरनेट, करेक्ट? नो, तो अंकुर हैज एडेड वन वेरी गुड पॉइंट, ही सेज एक्सेस, सिंगल एक्सेस पॉइंट, करेक्ट? नो, सो पोर्टल वर्ड वी एक्चुअली कम अक्रॉस हियर डिस्कशन समथिंग कॉल अंकुर हैज एडेड, गुड मॉर्निंग अंकुर, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन, single access point for centralized content management. Am I right? No? So what kind of content you normally see in a Facebook? तो शायद आपको नहीं लगता कि जो आप फेसबुक साइट यूज करो, दिस फेसबुक साइट इज आल्सो वेब एप्लीकेशन एंड इट इज अ वेब एप्लीकेशन यू कैन ऑलवेज एक्सेस बाय यूजिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर यूआरएल एंड इफ यू एक्सेस दिस एक्सेस इट इज ओनली फॉर ट्रस्टेड मेंबर्स. ओके, ओनली एक्सेसिबल फॉर ट्रस्टेड यूजर्स. हाउ डू ट्रस्ट द यूजर? दैट्स माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. हाउ डू ट्रस्ट द हाउ डू ट्रस्ट हाउ Do you trust the user? You treat your user as customer. And if you treat your user as a customer, that means what you do? You ask user to register, and if user registered, correct? No, let user provide. Okay, necessary details for registration, and if it is there, okay, approve user as customer. Based on policy, am I right? No. Based on the policy, आपको पता है, Facebook, YouTube, whatever website you try to access, they always do one thing. They always gives us policy. I think most of you do not read those policy documents, and we just select the button called next, next, next. And what happens? You become a member, and suddenly after a few days, you realize your photo has been seen somewhere in some particular ad, or you might find your videos has been shared with someone. Why? Because there are policies. I think we blindly accepted those policies, and because of that, now Facebook is the owner of our all content which you publish. Even I just go back and upload my video, even if I just go and upload my some good artistic photograph, correct? No, so that photograph, my ownership will be lost, because now this all kind of content which I created has been uploaded on my Facebook or WhatsApp. I think they are going to be part of whom now? WhatsApp. And they will decide how to use that material. Oh, that means we redefine. Yes, that is what exactly the policy is important. It's very important customer. It is very important normal user. It is very important approve. And such kind of web applications is called web portal. Correct? No? And there are millions of users are using this Facebook portal for getting people connected and sharing their own kind of thoughts in the form of videos, in the form of images, and they are building their social network. Okay, human being. Okay, what is the difference between human and other animals? Very simple thing I'm asking in this particular .NET core session, because I know it's a mindset game. What it differentiate human from the other animals? Can you guess? सुबह सुबह कोई बाबा रवि तांबड़ी का प्रवचन तो नहीं चल रहा है. I'm coming back to the quote. What is that? Humans love to be social. Okay, they love to stay in groups. They love to share their things, their thoughts, their emotions. Am I right? No. And that builds very good kind of bonding.
Even some kinds of animals also have, like,
some kind of animals. Group. Animals, yes, that is weird.
Yeah.
very good. Fantastic. So can I say human is animal then?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can really say, no, human is kind of animal. Okay, no, only thing, human has got some kind of developed brain. Okay, and because of that, he uses all his senses, okay, you know, for taking the full advantage of this particular social. And we really find we are still connecting with each other. We are still helping with each other. Main bolna kya chahta hu? Yes, social networking site is actually giving us humanity to be as a human for connecting this thing. Lekin ye sara karne ke liye humne use kya kiya? Portal. Portal gives you some kind of group, some kind of like a consortium, some kind of like a community. And under that community, we exchange our information. So this community, it is available on the web. We call it a web portal. And if it is a web portal, it is for one specific purpose, for keeping themselves connected. So if it is a web portal, how this web portal is? It is a web portal by using some particular social networking site. And if it is a social networking site, how this site is going to be there? The site is going to be as a web application. And what is this web application, my dear friend? All right, this is the web application is nothing but. Can you come across the word? What is the word? Distributed application. Koi to Sherlock Holmes ka story chal raha hai, aisa nahi lag raha hai? Distributed applications, we are focusing on this. So if it is a distributed application, yeah, distributed application, agar enterprise application hai, agar yeh distributed application, normal clients ra application hai, to yeh application kaha pe run ho raha hai? Are you getting question now? Distributed application, we just now talked about distributed application has got the two application components, client application and server application. Am I right now? Client application as nothing but your server application. I use the word here, server application somewhere. Let me just put that word here. It's a web application where the web applications are actually deployed to the web. And they are deployed to the web. See, web application jo web pe deploy kiya jata hai, they're deployed to web using multiple servers. Correct, no? तो हो सकता है उसमें से कुछ सर्वर्स को हम नाम देंगे वेब सर्वर्स. वी विल हैव सम काइंड ऑफ सर्वर्स व्हिच विल बी कॉल्ड एज वेब सर्वर्स, व्हिच विल बी कॉलिंग देम एज एप्लीकेशन सर्वर्स. वी माइट कॉल सर्टन सर्वर्स एज डिजिटल मीडिया सर्वर्स, और वी माइट कॉल सर्टन सर्वर्स एज नथिंग बट डेटाबेस servers, or we might have got certain servers which are responsible for managing our user credentials. Okay, something called domain or user directory servers, or there might be certain servers are available. Again, that servers, the analytics is going on. Have you observed when I just come across to this YouTube channel, I just shown you my certain video. For example, there's something called simple entity framework, crude operation using .NET Core something. Okay, and something is here called as multi-layer .NET Core application. Again, there's something called simple. Okay, there's a lot of things I will, if I just click any particular video, for example, when I just get that video, correct, now I get a lot of info in that video. If I just click on that video, I get that video here. My job is not to show the video. But if you just look around inside this video, have you seen some word here? What is it word? You are having a visual, your YouTube content given, and for that YouTube content, you just click on the option called analytics. And when I click this analytics option, what do you get? Aapko nahi lag raha hai, ye video ka analytics pura aapko dikhai de raha hai yahan pe? Yes, you really find this video has got 53 views since it was published. And when? In 190 days, how many things have been there? At the same time, average percentage viewed, average view duration. Okay, no? See more. Can you get the complete chart? Can you get the data? So ye aapko nahi lag raha hai ki this is something called behind some analytics works is going on. So there might be some particular machine learning techniques would have been used. Machine learning techniques would have been used, correct, no? For data analytics. Jitne sare logo ne ye video dekha hoga, those people who have seen that video, how many times that video has been watched? How many people have watched this video? How many people have completely watch the video, how many people have just click on the video, I think we really get this analytics. So where these things are happening, so shayad this all kind of things has been happening on something called big data cluster. Kya use kiya maine word yahan pe? Cluster, big data. Why? Because my video might have been seen by millions of people, and millions of people have watched that video, so they have actually given me the analytics data of the all million users data, and based on that I can find the analytics. So it's a big data, you know, like that I'm talking. And now it's Ravi Tambade's one video. Ravi Tambade might upload 100 videos. Ravi Tambade will keep adding something called thousands of videos, and one Ravi Tambade, like that way there are something called 10 million people who are daily might be uploading their videos, and they wanted to see their analytics. Liking of that video, don't think it's a big data now for a YouTube application. Very good. And how this happening? By using some algorithms, by using some kind of like a trending algorithms. And these trending algorithms are actually designed and has been applied on that particular big data, which is managed by using word called cluster. So ye aapko aise lag raha hai ki ye cluster ka matlab kya hai? What is cluster? Before getting to the coding word, no, main aapko niche lane ki koshish kar raha hu. Cluster, anybody remember what is cluster?
Group of data, group of machines.
Very good. So normally in our life, clustering concept to hame abhi ye lockdown mein to bahut achhi tarah se samajh mein aa gaya, correct no? In lockdown, how you release the cluster word? Wherever you find the corona positive case has been identified, correct no? If one particular family member has been identified as a corona positive, what exactly government does? Government allows, ask all the family members to get their test done. Am I right?
Yes.
And if all the family members have been identified as a corona positive, then what happens? I think this family is staying in one particular flat, in one building. So during that time, what the government is going to do? Government is going to find that particular building, and under the building, if there are 50 flats are there, 7-story or 8-story building, I think all apartment owners would have been asked to go for corona test. And if this whole building has been identified, all members have been identified as what? Corona positive. What the government is going to do? I think government is going to seal that building. Am I right? No? That means now these people have been asked to go for quarantine, and restrictions has been imposed for other people to come in the building. So aapko nahi lag raha hai this all kind of members has been clustered? Logical grouping. Kya word is coming yahan pe? Word clusters nahi, the word logical grouping. Now when I use the word cluster in our word, so can I have logical servers? Logical grouping of multiple servers. तो आपको नहीं लग रहा है बिग डेटा एप्लीकेशन जो आपका होगा यूट्यूब जैसा एप्लीकेशन है, तो फॉर दिस यूट्यूब एप्लीकेशन आई थिंक दिस बिग डेटा एप्लीकेशंस आर गोइंग टू बी इंस्टॉल ऑन मल्टीपल सर्वर्स, एंड दिस ऑल काइंड ऑफ मल्टीपल सर्वर्स हैज बीन लॉजिकली ग्रुप टुगेदर, एंड वी कॉल इट्स नथिंग बट समथिंग एज योर बिग डेटा क्लस्टर. एंड सच काइंड ऑफ बिग डेटा क्लस्टर्स व्हिच गोइंग टू कंटेन दिस टाइप्स ऑफ सर्वर्स वेयर एल्गोरिथम इज रनिंग इन अ वेरी फास्ट मैनर using multiple processes and all those things. At the same time, you also has got your directories where user credentials has been stored, username, password has been stored, user's personalized information has been stored. At the same time, there might be some kind of data which is supposed to be managed for business point of view. That data might have been stored under the database servers. And at the same time, you will have a lot of YouTube videos you upload, your pictures you upload, this pictures, binary data, streaming data might have been stored in a very high storage servers. We call them as digital media servers. And we will have some kind of like a logic, okay, trending, likes logic, something like logics, a core logic of YouTube content management applications would have been deployed here itself. And we will have a lot of web pages, we'll have a lot of HTML content that would have been kept on this web servers. So don't think whenever we talk about a web application, it is not just like a simple application. It is nothing but the application which has been deployed to the web, and deployed to the web means on multiple servers. And if multiple servers, what kind of servers I'm talking about, my dear friends? Not only one type of server, might be web servers, might be application servers, might be this thing doesn't require any knowledge of programming. But before getting to the programming word, first let us have bird's eye view. 4, database servers. 5, directory servers. What is the directory servers, I said, my friend? User credential management, login, password, register, all those things. You know, machine learning. Can I use a word here called 6? Artificial intelligence servers. Can you accept this word now? And can you just put that word? And can is this complete thing? And now here I come across a word called cluster. So from cluster, I just talk that information, just give idea about lockdown period, correct? No, and just I focus. It's a logical grouping of web servers. Can you see, my dear friend? This is what exactly is nothing but today's YouTube application. So if someone asks you a question, Ravi, can you explain what is YouTube application? Abhi aapko pata chal raha ki YouTube application is a web application deployed on multiple servers. Servers. So ye sare cheezon ke andar aapko ek word hamesha samne aa raha hai ki nahi? What is the word you are really coming across everywhere? Server. Logical multiple servers. So definitely question come to your mind. Hey, what is this server here? If I really want to get myself, my hands, I would like to make it dirty with this whole kind of Java application or .NET application or Python application or any kind of application. Yes, all web applications are actually called as a server applications. Correct, no? These are called as server applications. And .NET Core is used for building server applications, as well as .NET Core is also used to build applications which are nothing but your, what is that? Standard applications. So can I use .NET Core for building standard applications? Yes, I can use .NET Core to build this desktop applications. Can I use .NET Core for building distributed applications? Yes, you can use .NET Core for building this distributed applications. Can I use .NET Core for building my enterprise applications? Yes, I can. Can I use .NET Core for building this particular web application? Try to see. I think we ask question of our mind and try to see. Yes, .NET Core we can use for building this web applications. So can I use .NET Core for building applications for web server? Yes, that is what we call as ASP.NET web application, ASP.NET website. Okay, you know? Can I use .NET Core for writing the applications which will treat as a application servers? Yes, where I can write my own ASP.NET application services. Dekho, word change ho gaya. Website. Application services. Can I use my .NET Core for managing my media content? Yes, I could, by using something called as WPF, by using something here as 2D graphics, 3D graphics, correct, no? Or I can really go back and do all kind of work here, multimedia. Yes, I can do that work. Okay, no? Multimedia functionalities. Acha, can I use .NET Core for managing the database? Layman's point of view, I'm trying to explain. So whenever you have a question, you can always interrupt me and you could always ask me. Okay, no? So I think yes, we can do that work, database connectivity. लेकिन आपको पता है डेटाबेसेस अगर बात किया जाए तो डेटाबेस हमारे पास दो प्रकार के होते हैं. एक होता है एसक्यूएल डेटाबेस और एक होता है आपका क्या? कैन समबडी टेल मी?
नो
एसक्यूएल डेटाबेस. सो शायद यू माइट टॉक अबाउट समथिंग कॉल्ड लाइक माय एसक्यूएल डेटाबेस. यू माइट टॉक अबाउट समथिंग कॉल्ड लाइक ओरेकल डेटाबेस. यू टॉक अबाउट समथिंग लाइक इनग्रेस और पोस्टग्रेस. करेक्ट? नो, lot of things are there. Sybase, lot of things are there, correct? No, And we talk about NoSQL database. Can somebody tell me some database you might have come across? Listen, MongoDB, very good. Thank you, Shubham. Okay, you know, Cosmos DB, MongoDB. So can I learn this .NET core and can I really would be able to do programming against this so that I can deploy certain applications here. 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 I can also do one more thing. Can I really do something called authentication, authorization, you know, security part you talk about, web security. कि फेसबुक को साइट एक्सेस करने जाओगे तो फेसबुक का लॉगिन आईडी पासवर्ड अगर मैच होता है देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस फेसबुक पेज अदरवाइज यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू अलाउड कैन आई यूज माय जीमेल आईडी टू एक्सेस सर्टेन ई-कॉमर्स एप्लीकेशंस सो वी वांटेड समथिंग कॉल्ड हियर ऑथेंटिकेशन सो कैन आई यूज .NET कोर फॉर दैट यस .NET कोर आई कैन यूज लेट मी जस्ट पुट प्रॉपर्ली .NET कोर If you really want to get yourself into the C# language, no, first get the bird's eye view. Slightly, yeah. Right? Can I use a .NET core for my artificial intelligence? Oh, something new. Okay. Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, trending, clustering. Today, every application you are using in this world, it is backed up by artificial intelligence. You know, so can I use .NET Core for that? Yes. Internet of Things, IoT. Yes, you can use. Okay, machine learning, you can use. Computer vision. So that I can do image processing. And I can really write my application, which is something like a drone is flying on my farm. Correct, no? And during that time, the drone camera is actually capturing that video. And I'm actually doing some analysis over the video footage, which I'm getting. And accordingly, I'm guiding my drone. Correct, no? If there's any particular hurdle, like a tree's been there, my drone will identify that particular tree. And accordingly, my drone will change its route. And this is the way my drone will not get collide over the tree. So can I do that thing by using .NET Core? Yes. I'm trying to focus on this area. तो आपको नहीं लग रहा है कि कोई एक वेब एप्लीकेशन अगर आप देखना चाहोगे जो which are famous web applications, this famous web application consists of something which has been deployed on web server, something which has been deployed on as application server, something which has been deployed as a media server, and something which has been deployed as a data servers, something which has been deployed on your authentication server, something which has been deployed on these things. So kya ho raha hai? We are moving from one particular word. What is that word? We are moving from one particular word. That word actually I'm focusing here as what kind of word? Journey. From monolithic applications to distributed applications. So previously, whenever I talk about the monolithic applications, jo shayad when I started my job in 1997 in a company called CD Infotech. So during that time, we were developers. And being as a developer, you know, we were responsible for writing this monolithic applications. So we were responsible for writing like a text editor applications. We were responsible for writing like a paintbrush applications. We were responsible for writing like a Microsoft Word applications. We were responsible for writing our applications, something which is nothing but like an image processing, you know, Windows-based applications. I'm talking about the days of 1990. Okay, now today, whenever I see in the industry, I think monolithic applications are very rarely getting developed, but the applications which are getting developed, these applications are called as distributed applications. And if these are distributed applications, so during that time, you are trying to use Word, but you are not using Word. What you're using now? Office 365. You wanted to do some kind of like documents, correct? No, you're using something called Google Docs. You're using something called Am I right? Can I just show you something? कम बैक. यानी अभी भी अगर आपको कोई डॉक्यूमेंट बने तो आप क्या करते हो, यू डोंट रिक्वायर्ड एनी सॉफ्टवेयर टू बी इंस्टॉल ऑन योर कंप्यूटर. व्हाट इज रियली रिक्वायर्ड, यू जस्ट गो बैक हियर एंड जस्ट क्लिक हियर समथिंग कॉल रवि तांबड़े लॉग इन, सिलेक्ट द ऑप्शन, कैन यू गेट हियर समथिंग कॉल डॉक, यू क्लिक ऑन द डॉक. When you click on the dock, what exactly happened? You do not get any particular desktop application launch, but in a browser itself, you can really have a web page under that browser web page where you see docs.google.com, and you really find this option called, do you want to create a blank document? So in a browser itself, I click and I really get a very good kind of document editor. And I really type it here. Welcome to Transflower. Okay. Mentor as a service. Learn by doing. Okay. First, get bird's eye view. Then take a leap. Get your hands dirty only when you have a vision. Am I right? Did I write some document? Yes, I really created certain content. I really wanted this content to be created as a document file. So what I can do one more thing. Can I just do one thing? I created the document and you just do one thing. Can I select the option called share? Can I attach some comment? Can I share this document? So I want this document to be written as here called learning. What is that? Transflower learning. So I really want to make this document to be saved as a Transflower learning. Save. Don't think this document has been saved? Yes, this document has been saved. I wanted this document to be shared with someone. So can I just go back and type here something called Ankur? Oh, Ankur, are you there right now? Yes, Ankur. I have got Ankur's email address. I like to share this document with Ankur. I like to go back and I like to share this document with Rohit. I really want to go back and select Rohit. What is your email address? Can you just tell me? This one, no?
No, it's rohit.vasagadekar.
Yeah, Rohit dot, yes. I have Rohit, Rohit Palmer is there. Okay, Rohit, 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 Rohit.
rohit.vasaga.
V-A, no, W, Rohit.
Dot V-A-S-A.
Dot V, V, no?
Yes, last one.
That is correct, no? Yes. So now Ankur, Rohit, again, if I just go back and try to use something called Vishwambar, Vishwambar. So actually I'm just giving certain users name and I'm just trying to add, okay. Here is the document I like to share with you. And if I just press button called send. And do you want them to be make as an editor, viewer, or commentator? I would like to make this all people will be able to edit this document. When I select option called send, all are editors. So you are sharing this document outside of your Transflower organizations. Do you want to share anyway? Yes, I shared it. Rohit, I hope you have got your laptop right now open. Ankur, you have your laptop open right this moment. Can you see Gmail account mail has been received to you? Yes, Ankur, can you see that link for the document is also available?
Yes.
Can you click on the document and just try to modify this document? Rohit, can you just try if you have right now in front of your PC? I like to tell you the microservices and this whole kind of thing idea where the .NET comes to picture. Koi technically coding se samajhna nahi, pehle basic samjho. Ankur?
Got the invitation to edit.
Yeah, I think the document has been shared. So you might have received the email.
Yes.
Can you click that email and under that, can you share your screen for time being? I'll just allow to share your screen. Ye pura .NET ka seekhna hai na, this is a new way of learning. We have to always follow.
Okay.
Let me just do one thing. Ankur is right now getting connected. Ankur, you're getting connected from where? Can you just tell me? Aapka city kaun sa hai?
Hazaribagh.
Pardon?
Hazaribagh.
Jharkhand, okay. Can you share your screen now? I allowed you to share your screens. So, good. So we could really find here, document is opened by whom? Ankur, no? And Ankur get the same kind of content available. So tell me, Ankur and Ravi Tamre, did they use any desktop application? No, they did not use any desktop applications. And have you seen something important? Now see, I could really see Ankur is typing certain data, but at the same time, can I just go back and do something? See, something is happening. Ankur's screen is getting visible and you suddenly see Ravi Tamre's name, correct, no? Hi, Ankur. Very happy to see you in this virtual classroom. Would you please tell me, all of you, whose screen you are observing at this moment? You are observing screen of Ankur Prasad's screen, correct? Ankur's Prasad screen. And who is typing at this moment? Ravi Tamre. So don't think one document is kept somewhere at the server side and now there are two users are parallelly working on that document. तो आपको नहीं लग रहा है कि एक प्रकार का एक वेब है ये माइक्रोसॉफ्ट का वर्ड है नो ये वर्ड एप्लीकेशन डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन है क्या नहीं डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन का मतलब होता क्या है द एप्लीकेशन यूज ओनली वन यूजर एट अ टाइम बट राइट नाउ इफ आई ऐड ऑल दोस 14 पार्टिसिपेंट्स अंडर दैट डॉक्यूमेंट एज अ कोलैबोरेटर नो आई थिंक 14 पीपल कैन स्टार्ट टाइपिंग डॉक्यूमेंट अंकुर कैन यू स्टार्ट टाइपिंग अंडर द डॉक्यूमेंट एंड एट द सेम टाइम आई ऑल्सो लाइक टू टाइप द डॉक्यूमेंट यस सो आई एम एडिंग Have you seen Ankur is also typing at the same time Ravi Tamre is also typing? So what is this? Is it a desktop application? It is not a desktop application. It is the application which is nothing but now we call application as cloud application. Kya word use kiya maine abhi? I use word cloud application. So if you use Docs, if you use spreadsheet, if you use any kind of applications today's word, these applications are now being called as cloud applications. Thank you, Ankur, for sharing your screen. Would you please stop sharing your screen? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, I hope my screen is visible now. Whether my screen is visible, do let me know.
Yes.
Yeah. So what exactly I was trying to point it out here. What did we use? We use Microsoft, so we use Google Doc. So what is Google Doc? I use what here? What is the word I use here? It's a cloud app. Can we just do one thing? If I come back to this browser, I'm just select on this area and again select back. Whenever you try to access any particular browser page and you just try to type something or tap, if you logged in, you by default get this Google page. And when you get the Google page, have you seen when I just take my cursor over here, what is that icon or tooltip has been shown to you? When my mouse goes over this particular number of dots, 9 dots, what do you see here at the below getting displayed?
Google Apps.
Google Apps. Can you get the word here? Word? Google Apps. So what is Google Apps? Google Doc. Google Spreadsheet. Google Meet. These all are called as Google Apps because they are given by whom? They are given by Google. But these Google Apps are nothing but what? They are called cloud apps. So what is this cloud app? What is this cloud app? It's a cloud application. Now what is a cloud application? Can I say cloud is nothing but web? Can I say cloud? Cloud is nothing but internet. What is cloud? Internet. Someone like to add some word? Web, internet. It's a network of networks. Am I right? Yes, perfect, right? So, if this cloud app is, so this application kaha pe run ho raha? This application is running inside cloud. So, how these cloud applications are running? So, can I use your cloud apps are running on some platform? These cloud applications are running on some particular platform. What is that platform, my dear friend? This cloud app. What this cloud app consists of? This cloud app consists of services. This cloud app consists of front end. This cloud app consists of web application. This cloud app consists of services. This cloud app consists of backend. Okay, no? This front end, if it is a Google, if I talk about Google Docs, so definitely the front end they might use here as Angular, because Angular, it is the front end technology given by Google. So definitely Google will be using their front end technology to make this application look beautiful in your web pages, Angular. What kind of web application they're using? They might be using some kind of Apache technologies, Apache servers. Other Apache servers, they might be writing something called as web applications. Correct, no? Behind whatever logic they would like to write for this thing, they might have written lot of web services. These web services which have been given, these web services they have deployed by using a concept that consists something called as microservices. And behind these microservices, they might have got the complete backend been managed properly. देखो ये ऐसा कुछ application शायद आप Google का doc use करना शायद होगा. तो ये application run हो तो how this application running? So they are actually cloud apps. This cloud apps actually consist of this whole kind of thing. This cloud apps are running on certain platform. तो ये cloud apps किस platform पे run हो रहे? अगर ये Google का होगा, तो Google के ये cloud app कहाँ पे run हो रहा है? ये Google का cloud app is running on Kubernetes platform. अच्छा ऐसा कोई तो Kubernetes platform cloud ने बना के रखा है, Google ने बना के रखा है, जहां पे ये cloud application run हो रहे हैं. तो ये Kubernetes का platform का मतलब है क्या? It is a kind of environment where, okay, cloud apps are run using some kind of exe execution boundaries. ऐसे कुछ तो execution boundaries है which are scalable. Which are durable, which are elastic, which are secure, which are loosely coupled, highly cohesive. ऐसा कुछ नहीं लग रहा है, ऐसा कुछ तो है टेक्नोलॉजीज, करेक्ट नो? कुछ तो कुबेरनेटिस नाम का कुछ तो कॉन्सेप्ट गूगल ने यूज किया है जिसके ऊपर ये आपके क्लाउड के एप्लीकेशंस डिप्लॉय किए हैं, और उस एप्लीकेशन के अंदर उनका फ्रंट एंड है, उसका एप्लीकेशन सर्वर है जहां पे उसके एप्लीकेशन का लॉजिक है, उसके पीछे बहुत सारी वेब सर्विसेस है जहां पे कुछ माइक्रो सर्विसेस करके लॉजिक लिखा रखा है, एंड द डेटा इज बिट कनेक्टेड. ऐसे एप्लीकेशन का जो प्लेटफॉर्म है वो प्लेटफॉर्म कौन सा है? कुबेरनेटिस प्लेटफॉर्म है, जो गूगल की टेक्नोलॉजीज है वहां पे एप्लीकेशन डिप्लॉय किए. तो ये प्लेटफॉर्म कहाँ पे है, ये प्लेटफॉर्म कहाँ पे रन हो रहा है? दैट्स द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो डेफिनेटली दिस काइंड ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट माइट हैव बीन क्रिएटेड ऑन गूगल्स इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, क्लाउड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. तो ये क्लाउड का इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कौन सा है यार? सो अगर मैं गूगल डॉक्स की बात करता हूँ, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट गूगल डॉक्स, इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट समथिंग कॉल्ड गूगल स्प्रेडशीट, सो व्हाट इज दैट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर? तो आपके मशीन पे रन हो रहा है क्या? राइट नाउ अंकुर हैज ओपन दैट पर्टिकुलर डॉक्यूमेंट, इवन रवि तांबड़े आल्सो ओपन दैट डॉक्यूमेंट, रवि तांबड़े आल्सो वेंट बैक टू दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग एंड स्टार्टेड मॉडिफाइंग दैट डॉक्यूमेंट, करेक्ट नो? तो शायद आई थिंक द डॉक्यूमेंट वाज क्रिएटेड कॉल्ड ट्रांसफर लर्निंग, यू कैन रियली सी रवि तांबड़े ट्रांसफर डॉक्यूमेंट्स देयर. टेल मी वेदर दिस डॉक्यूमेंट इज राइट नाउ स्टोर्ड इन माय मशीन. यस प्रियदर्शनी, मयूर, मयूरेश, आपको लग रहा है ये डॉक्यूमेंट मेरे मशीन पे है या क्लाउड पे है?
क्लाउड पे
हाँ तो क्लाउड पे है तो means कहाँ पे means not on my machine that I understand yes no so the document right now which I modified the document which I shared it is not physically installed physically stored on my machine then where it is stored in cloud so in cloud which cloud
application server
in Google cloud very good Vishwambar I'm coming to that point to cloud कौन सा cloud Google अभी ये कौन सा application है docs तो docs is a kind of cloud app given by whom this cloud app is given by whom tell me google company okay you know it's a google company so if it's a google company has created this cloud app and google company has deployed this cloud app on some kind of their platform that platform is something called kubernetes lekin ye platform jiske upar khada karke rakha hai that platform is actually been given on the top of what some kind of infrastructure to wo kaun sa infrastructure hai उस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हमने बोला क्लाउड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर तो क्लाउड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का मतलब क्या गूगल क्लाउड अभी गूगल क्लाउड का मतलब क्या इन गूगल डेटा सेंटर्स कहीं नो यस गूगल डेटा सेंटर तो गूगल डेटा सेंटर का मतलब क्या अ काइंड ऑफ फिजिकल एनवायरमेंट वेयर huge computational resources are available for running your millions of servers petabytes of data can be stored in such kind of high storage devices where this is going to grow and we will be able to manage our data to jitne bhi sare main document banana chahta hu main apna document banata jaunga this all kind of document will be stored in this google data centers this document I will share with 100 or 2000 people and 2000 people can modify that document at the same time and that traffic is managed so we really require very high computing resources high computing servers high computing devices ram ultimately kya dekha jaye data center ka matlab kya where you have got exponential ram available you have got millions of cpus available you will get billions of gpus available you will get extensible storage capacity hai ki nahi to ram yes mayur aapka jo laptop abhi aap use kar rahe ho can you tell me how much ram you have for your laptop at this moment 8 GB correct no 8 GB is a ram available for Mayur's laptop my laptop has got 16 gigabytes of ram but when you talk about like a google doc application jo google doc application abhi use karo ye application there are millions of users are using at this moment if millions of users are using this google app which is called doc and they are writing millions of documents they are sharing these millions of document aapko nahi lag raha hai I think it really requires at this moment something called more than 8-9 terabytes of ram for running that google doc so that millions of users can access to itna ram possible hai ki aapke paas nahi but actually this data center gives you that ever demanding cpu ever demanding gpu for machine learning algorithms to run for millions of data at the same time using parallel computing and also jitna bhi sara data aa raha hai wo data ko store karne ke liye huge capacity of storage required that everything is given under the data center aise data centers I think google have created across the globe to shayad ho sakta hai okay more than 20 to 30 locations in this world correct no google data centers would have been created and these data centers would have been connected correct no by using fiber optics okay mera topic hai programming world agar programming world ke andar ghusna hai uske andar penetrate karna hai if you want to go inside in a very perfect manner aapko bird's eye view leke aapko jump karna padega to ye hai aapka डेटा सेंटर यहाँ पे करके रखा है तो अगर ये डेटा सेंटर इतना दे के रखा है तो उसके ऊपर एप्लीकेशन बनाना है तो डेफिनेटली द काइंड ऑफ एप्लीकेशन वांट टू क्रिएट करे नो क्रिएटिंग डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन माइंडसेट इज डिफरेंट and creating cloud ready application mindset is different. Don't you think? Yes or no? Tell me. ये पूरा रामायण महाभारत बताने की रवि को क्यों जरूरत पड़ रही है? Because most of the time, when you are learning .NET Core, when you are learning C Sharp, we don't understand the bird's eye view, and we directly jump into the coding, and we just get ourselves engrossed with the syntax. Class कैसे लिखना है, variable कैसे लिखना है, function कैसे लिखना है, public function कैसे लिखना है? We learn only syntactical way, and because of that, you are not able to distinguish how to really start working with an application, how to really distinguish the requirements and try to build the application. Because you have बहुत बार ये lacking होता है. तो आपको नहीं लग रहा है बिल्डिंग अ माइक्रोसॉफ्ट नोटपैड एप्लीकेशन बिल्डिंग माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड एप्लीकेशन इट्स अ वन काइंड ऑफ माइंडसेट. व्हाट इज दैट माइंडसेट? ईएक्सई, एग्जीक्यूटेबल एप्लीकेशन. एंड व्हेन यू आर बिल्डिंग दिस क्लाउड रेडी एप्लीकेशन, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एप्लीकेशन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट? आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन समथिंग कॉल्ड गूगल डॉक, गूगल स्प्रेडशीट. तो ये एप्लीकेशन बनाने का मतलब क्या? यू हैव टू बिल्ड नाउ नॉट ओनली EXE, बट यू नीड टू बिल्ड व्हाट? यू नीड टू बिल्ड नाउ क्लाउड ऐप. तो ये क्लाउड ऐप होगा तो उसका प्लेटफॉर्म, इसका इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्या है? डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन का इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्या है? कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर डेस्कटॉप एप्लीकेशन? सिंगल computer. What is the platform for the single computer? You always call that word, here's nothing but operating environment, correct? No, what is the operating environment for single computer? You always call revisor, it is the operating system. Acha, then whatever the desktop application you create, what is that? It is nothing but an actual application. That is your executable, correct? No. Executable. That is your EXE. Now, when I talk about the cloud application, when I talk about the cloud app, and when I talk about desktop app, please understand. Interview time. People always think about the architecture. People always think about the patterns. People always think about the principles. They wanted to understand this. So here, the infrastructure. What is it? I talk of example something called GoDoc. What is your infrastructure? Here, the single machine. Here, the what? In case of cloud application, it is a data center. And under the data centers, you'll get something called वर्चुअल सर्वर. क्या वर्ड यूज़ किया? देखो कहां से जर्नी शुरू हुई थी. वर्चुअल सर्वर और यू कैन कॉल द वर्ड एज वर्चुअल मशीन, करेक्ट नो? अच्छा, यहाँ पे जो मशीन था ये कौन सा मशीन है? दैट इज अ फिजिकल मशीन, एम राइट? नो. एंड व्हाट इज दिस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर? विल कंटेन डेटा, वर्चुअल मशीन. एंड ऑन दैट वर्चुअल मशीन व्हाट विल हैव? यू रिक्वायर अ प्लेटफॉर्म. सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्लेटफॉर्म विल हैव इट अंडर दैट वर्चुअलाइज्ड एनवायरमेंट? That environment which you won't have platform, and that platform will be something called virtualized platform. What that platform we are talking about today in this word? Containerized to shayad main iski baat kar raha hu. Kaun si? Kubernetes shayad main yahan pe baat kar raha hu. Google data center. And now I'm coming back. What is that? What is your application? Now this application I'm talking about, you know, containerized application which will contain web application as well as microservices. Are you getting? Aur jab main yahan pe baat karta hu iska matlab kya hota hai? I'm talking about executables plus libraries. क्या बोला मैंने यहाँ पे? Oh, that means I'm talking about if it's a Microsoft Windows, I'll get .exe files and plus I'll get a lot of .dls. And when I talk about the cloud applications, what I really find here? Web application, website, plus microservices. Are you getting? So today, if you want to make one application, which is nothing but text editor application. So being as a desktop application, you develop here as Word application. And whenever you like to develop this as a cloud application, you'll develop it here as a Google Doc application. But this time you will not use word called application, but this time, what is the word you're using now? App. Are you getting? तो ये सारी चीजों के अंदर आपको क्या दिखाई दे रहा है, आप कौन सा भी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर यूज करो, कौन सा भी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम यूज करो, जो भी आप एप्लीकेशन बनाने वाले हो, दिस एप्लीकेशंस आर ऑलवेज गोइंग टू रन, दिस एप्लीकेशंस विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय, क्या वर्ड यूज किया मैंने यहाँ पे, व्हाट इज द वर्ड माय डियर फ्रेंड आई यूज्ड हियर? Have you seen the word which I used? Runtime. Acha, runtime. So here runtime kaun sa hoga? This runtime could be Python. This runtime could be .NET Core. This runtime could be Java. This runtime could be Node.js. Correct, no? Hai ki nahi? And where this runtime will run? Where this runtime will run? Okay. Your applications will be built. Your applications will be run by using runtime. These runtimes will be run within a container. These containers will be managed by using container environment. This container environments will be run using, okay, cloud. These clouds will be managed by using data centers. So if I really think about, here is my doc app. This doc app, if I'm using Microsoft.NET technology, if I want to develop this application like using Microsoft technology, so in this case, I will use my runtime. My runtime will be which runtime? .NET Core runtime. This runtime which I want to run it here, I will require some kind of web technology related support. So my web technology related support will be here something called ASP.NET Core. I really require a front end for this particular application. So I'll require something might be Angular or might be React or might be Vue.js. Okay, and this everything I will like to run by using what? I like to run by using containers. So can I use here something called Docker container? This Docker containers, which we really talk about here, I cannot afford to have this kind of physical infrastructure. So can I use here something called Microsoft Azure Cloud? And under this Microsoft Azure Cloud, I'll use on rented basis. And on that thing, I may try to create some particular virtual machine in this Microsoft Azure. This Microsoft Azure virtual machine, which will be running under Mumbai data center of Microsoft. Can you see the complete picture? Yes, my dear friend. Aajkal ka zamana ye hai. 1997 ka zamana ye tha. But still, there are certain people who wanted to create the application as a desktop application. There are certain people who want to create the application as a cloud application. Can I use only one technology for building desktop applications as well as cloud applications? Yes, here goes your .NET Core. Can we have only one particular technology, .NET Core? Can we have its one particular technology to develop web applications? Can I have one particular technology for writing my own databases and all kind of environment like a cloud? Okay, this is what exactly is now present day, where lot of desktop applications which were developed somewhere 15 years before, 20 years before, are getting migrated as a cloud-based applications. So definitely the mindset which is required for that also need to be changed. Hame abhi exe file, DLL file से मूव होके हमें कहां पे जाना पड़ेगा? वेब एप्लीकेशन. हमें कहां पे जाना पड़ेगा? वेब सर्विसेज. हमें कहां पे जाना पड़ेगा? फ्रंट एंड यूजिंग एंगुलर, रिएक्ट और व्यू डॉट जेएस और माइट बी जेक्वेरी. जावास्क्रिप्ट फ्रेमवर्क. क्या बात किया मैंने? जावास्क्रिप्ट फ्रेमवर्क. और ये सारा करने के लिए शुरुआत कहां से होगी? .NET कोर्स से. तो करना क्या पड़ेगा? व्हाटएवर सॉल्यूशन यू मेक, व्हाटएवर, ओके, व्हाटएवर एप्लीकेशन यू वांट टू बिल्ड इट एज सॉल्यूशन. व्हाट इज द वर्ड यूज़र? बिल्ड इट एज सॉल्यूशन. So can I build this solution? Can I build this solution using Visual Code? With the help of .NET Core and .NET Core SDK. See? This is all kind of 1.5 hour discussion which I carried out. I come back to my point. And under that solution, what you'll have? तो आप जो भी कुछ करना चाहते हो, cloud application बनाना चाहते हो या कुछ भी बनाओगे, क्या करोगे आप हमेशा? You'll always build a solution. What is solution? What is solution? Solution will contain multiple projects. Okay, what is solution? You want to build your software. You want to build like a Microsoft Google application, Google application or Microsoft Word application. So ye karna hai to karna karega. Aapko being as a developer, you know, being as developer, start from scratch. How? Start building solution. If I want to start building solution, first I need to understand what is solution. Am I right? Solution is a kind of logical container. Solution is a kind of container. That container will contain multiple project. Then question comes, what is project? Correct, no? What is project according to our development word? Collection of source files and resource files. Oh, what is source files? I'm talking about if it's a Microsoft.NET, you'll have .cs files. Oh, that means what do you call? C# files. Okay, what are resource files? You require some kind of metadata. You might require some kind of file which are called .json files. You might require some kind of configuration files. You might require some particular files which are called like images, something like videos, you know, or might be some kind of files which are like a font files. What kind of source files you'll have? You'll have some C# files. You will have some kind of .html files. You'll have some kind of .css files. You'll have some kind of files which are your .javascript files. You might have some particular extra file which are your XML files. Are you getting, no, my dear friends? Okay. तो शायद वी हैव टू लर्न व्हाट इज दैट वी हैव टू लर्न कैन आई स्टार्ट वर्किंग विद माय सी शार्प अंडर दिस सी शार्प अंडर दिस डॉट सी एस फाइल यू हैव टू यूज सी शार्प कोड यहां पे आप क्या यूज करोगे यू यूज योर सी शार्प कोड हियर यू यूज योर presentation logic using HTML code. Here you use your cascaded style sheet which will contain your style sheets. Here you'll use some kind of scripting logic for validation purpose, for beautiful dynamic user interface perspective. You will use your JavaScript code. Here you wanted to define some metadata. Okay, you know? Data, metadata, or might you use some kind of file which are .txt files, or you might store certain data by using like .dat file. .data file means .dat file, correct? No. Yeah, आप अपना खुद का binary file extension भी दे सकते हो. तो नहीं आपको लग रहा है कि अगर आपको ये पूरा एप्लीकेशन बिल्डअप करना है तो शायद आप विजुअल कोड का यूज करके यू फर्स्ट क्रिएट अ ब्लैंक सॉल्यूशन अंडर द ब्लैंक सॉल्यूशन यू क्रिएट मल्टीपल प्रोजेक्ट्स वेयर सम प्रोजेक्ट विल बी कंसोल एप्लीकेशन प्रोजेक्ट सम प्रोजेक्ट माइट बी क्लास लाइब्रेरी प्रोजेक्ट सम प्रोजेक्ट माइट बी वेब application project some project might be desktop application project some project might be IoT based application project or some project might contain web services project are you getting तो मैं बोलूंगा यस आई विल क्रिएट दिस प्रोजेक्ट आई विल क्रिएट दिस प्रोजेक्ट दिस ऑल काइंड ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स आई विल कीप अंडर वन कंटेनर दैट कंटेनर विल बी कॉल्ड सॉल्यूशन एंड दैट इज द सॉल्यूशन व्हिच आई लाइक टू डिलीवर एंड फॉर दैट थिंग आई एम गोइंग टू यूज माय डॉट नेट तो शायद आवर जर्नी शुड स्टार्ट विद बिल्डिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन सो सी इन दिस वन एंड हाफ आवर आई टुक माय क्लास फॉर मेकिंग यू कंफर्टेबल ऑफ हैविंग व्हिच व्यू Eagle view. Whenever eagle wanted to find its prey, what it does? It doesn't go on a ground and start looking for the prey. Okay? Eagle takes a jump, goes to the height, and from that height, he just watches that area. He gets bird's eye view, and he spot. He finds, he track his prey, and then he dives inside. Don't think we really require this bird's eye view and this particular eagle mindset. For getting ourselves into this particular .NET world journey. That's why I did not start my today's session by using Hello World. In your colleges, in your institutes, in your corporate trainings, every time the session was always getting started with writing Hello World program. And people are writing Hello World program. People are writing variables. People are writing if statements. People are writing for statements. People are writing classes. People are writing interfaces. People are writing inheritance. People are following polymorphism. People are writing code. And people are still not understanding why the hell I'm doing this whole code. Because you don't have the bird's eye view while starting your journey to the programming. Now you understand. Oh, that means this .NET core, we have to use it for building application for what? Cloud applications. And if you want to build a cloud applications, it is going to be distributed. If it is going to be distributed, it is going to contain something as a client code. It is going to contain something called server code. If it is a server code, that might be in the form of website, in the form of microservices. If it is in the form of web application, that will be in the form of web pages, XML files, HTML files. And if it is going to be like a logic, the logic will be in the form of web services. And if these are the things where these are going to be deployed, these are going to be deployed in a containerized environment, Kubernetes, Azure Container Service, Amazon Container Service. And these container services are running where inside the Amazon Cloud or Google Cloud or Microsoft Azure Cloud. Ye cloud hai kahan pe? There are multiple data centers created by these companies are connected by using fiber optics. यहाँ पे कहीं तो जाके हमारा application run होने वाला है, where the application which is scalable would have been accessed by millions of users, but still application doesn't get crash. So I want to create my application which is scalable, which is elastic in its nature, and this application will consume sometimes 4GB RAM or sometimes 4 TB of RAM. So I really want to make my application which is scalable for this elastic media, which is a cloud. So definitely I should have a mindset of solution development approach. What is the approach said here? Solution development approach. And if I want to do it here, why don't I do my practical by creating that solution right from the scratch using my demos and really try to create something called here as an e-commerce application. Can I really create my e-commerce application? You can take any particular project, but I think this e-commerce application is the best platform to understand this whole cloud concept and .NET core concept and C# syntax and microservice architecture. And you can really have practical exposure. So I really wanted our next journey, which will be continued, you know, where we'll try to build e-commerce solution. Where we'll write some kind of unit test application. Where we'll try to create some kind of reusable libraries, just 2 minutes, or we might try to create some kind of website. We might write some kind of website, not only website, we also write some kind of REST API. We will also try to create some kind of desktop application, like in e-commerce application, the store manager, correct? No? Store manager. Who is actually being part of that warehouse where all the goods have been kept and he wanted to maintain the inventory. So can this inventory application will be desktop application, which is a part of this e-commerce solution. So e-commerce solution will contain some unit test console applications, some particular reusable libraries, some particular website will contain some kind of Windows based application, will contain some rest of the rest APIs, and they all are getting, no? This is what exactly our next work we would like to continue. So we would like to have a kind of step-by-step instructions to create this particular solution right from the scratch. Let us start with Visual Code. Okay, so this was my theory topic which I want to cover in this particular 1.5 hour. We have got only 5 minutes. Uska demo shayad hum tomorrow se karne wale, lekin aaj ye mindset zaruri tha. I'm using 5 minutes time. Just allow me to get a 5 minutes time just to get some kind of questions based on these things which I just discussed. So I hope you understood this, whatever I said. Aaj ka topic agenda kya tha? Can somebody ask, understood the agenda? Aaj ka topic agenda kya tha? Can you just guess, look very well? Recap, and after recap, the whole focus was what area? Have you observed? Correct, no? Was that the approach which I took for almost 1.5 hour, where I introduced you concept? Distributed application, web application, portal, cloud, cloud app, something which I would use called Kubernetes environment, Kubernetes platform. Don't worry about this technological words. We will really do the whole work in a very well. I use some kind of word here as a container. Here I use some kind of word here as a virtual server. Did I come across a word here, something called data center? So before jumping into the coding, if I could understand these words very well, I think every time when I revisit in my next coming sessions while doing the coding, I can correlate and try to show you, acha iske liye hum class likh rahe, iske liye hum interface likh rahe, iske liye hum method likh rahe, iske liye hum wo component bana rahe, iske liye hum jaake uski service bana rahe, so that we can correlate. Okay, that's why I took this particular thinking approach for getting ready for cloud based applications. And with that, we are actually about to jump into the level of what have you observed? What's that area? Programming world. And now in a programming world, start learning C# syntax, start learning building applications, start learning the artifacts of the programming, learn natural of thinking, object orientation using this solution. So 1.5 hour was spent for this. Tomorrow morning when we come back, it's complete hands-on oriented. We will try to build our own solution. तो यहाँ पे फिर हमें आगे जाके सीखना पड़ेगा ऐसे कौन से कमांड्स है जिसको यूज करके मैं बना सकता हूँ. So .NET new. One command we tried, .NET new. तो शायद यहाँ पे .NET new solution हो सकता है. .NET new console हो सकता है. .NET new क्लास लाइब्रेरी हो सकता है. .NET new ओके विंडोज एप्लीकेशन हो सकता है. ओ दैट मींस यू रियली नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड नाउ दिस .NET कमांड्स एंड यू नीड टू गेट योरसेल्फ कंफर्टेबल विथ राइटिंग दिस .NET कमांड्स. तो ये कौन से कमांड्स होगी? दिस ऑल काइंड ऑफ कमांड्स वी विल लाइक टू लर्न फ्रॉम टुमारो ऑनवर्ड्स. दिस आर कॉल्ड .NET CLI. क्या लिखा मैंने यहाँ पे? सो वी वॉन्ट टू डू दिस वर्क यूजिंग प्रैक्टिकल बाय लर्निंग CLI. आपको पता है दो वर्ड्स आपने हमेशा सुना होगा, GUI एंड अनदर वर्ड यू यूज वर्ड कॉल CLI. कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ GUI? ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस. तो शायद ये आप हमेशा विजुअल स्टूडियो यूज करके करते हो ना. सो यूज विजुअल स्टूडियो, यू यूज इक्लिप्स और यूज STS स्प्रिंग बूट के लिए, करेक्ट नो? CLI का मतलब क्या? कमांड लाइन यूटिलिटीज टू क्रिएट प्रोजेक्ट, टू क्रिएट सॉल्यूशन, टू क्रिएट लाइब्रेरीज. सो व्हेन यू आर लर्निंग .NET, नो वी आर यूजिंग दिस .NET CLI कमांड्स. सो दिस आर द .NET CLI कमांड्स वी विल लर्न इट, वी विल यूज इट फ्रॉम टुमारो ऑनवर्ड्स. But before getting ourselves into making your hands dirty, as I said, that first understand the bird's eye view, and then we will jump it here. So, शायद इसमें से एक command आपने try किया, am I right? No, this command you tried for creating simple console-based application using C#. But tomorrow we will use all those things and we learn C# syntax gradually. तो हमारा main purpose क्या है? Creating a solution. Under the solution, creating a project, and under the project, using C#, and under the C#, then our job is to learn what? Classes, interfaces, delegates, events, then arrays, collection, enumeration. Dynamic programming, async programming, and so things that will be continued, and like that way things will go. So step by step we would continue this whole kind of journey. Okay my dear friends, I hope today's session was slightly different than your normal educational sessions, normal YouTube video sessions, where we really have a world globe round and we come back to the right point. I know most of you are working and most of you are about to get login to your job, correct? No, so they can, means we can stop at this moment. But before that, can you just have some questions for myself, which I will try to address? Otherwise I'll just keep those questions and I'm just having for the thing. Okay Rohit, you have a client meeting, thank you very much, correct? No, so tomorrow we'll have the hands on thing. Okay, I'll be so helpful.
Yes sir.
Great, thank you Rohit. So most of you have your client call. So I think we can also terminate. But before that, you have time at this point just to have some kind of questions for me? Yes, Ravi? Ravi, you are coming from Oracle background. Am I right?
Yes.
Good. So I think Ravi right now, he is from Baroda and he is also joined for this particular learning part, correct? No, where he is actually working on Oracle applications. So mere khayal se Oracle application ek pura suit hai jahan pe jaake aap apne business requirement ke hisab se customization kar rahe ho. Am I right? No,
correct. Oracle Fusion application.
Ha, yeah, yani aisa koi right from the scratch programming nahi hota. Wahan pe Oracle ka kuch platform hai, wahan pe uska framework hai, wahan pe jaake business requirement ke hisab se aapko coding karna padta hai, correct? No,
correct. Yeah.
ओके तो शायद ये ओरेकल ऐप का जो पूरा कोडिंग आप अपने कंपनी के अंदर जहां पे कर रहे हो शायद यू आर यूजिंग मोस्टली जावा एज अ लैंग्वेज करेक्ट नो
या जावा देन देयर आर ईएल एक्सप्रेशंस एंड फॉर रिपोर्ट्स एंड एनालिटिक्स वी डू यूज एसक्यूएल क्वेरीज
ओके दैट मींस एसक्यूएल जावा एंड योर अदर काइंड ऑफ स्टफ यू आर यूजिंग करेक्ट नो लेकिन ये ओरेकल एप्लीकेशंस का .NET से भी कुछ कुछ संबंध है क्या
Yeah, when we do integrations between cross applications, like sometimes client have already an application deployed on .NET server,
yeah,
and they are now buying ERP, Oracle ERP. So we need to have that integrations for that. Build an interface. We do develop .NET codes.
Yeah, that means what we really understand from Ravi's conversation. That means the company who have already purchased Oracle application suite. For their business applications automation so it might happen that today company has decided to go for Oracle apps migration but at the same time last from 15 years they have developed a lot of .NET line of business applications and they are working very fine they wanted to integrate their existing applications of .NET with this Oracle applications so integration is required and during that integration the knowledge of .NET as well as the knowledge of your Oracle Java are getting interoperated together correct no Ravi तो आजकल के जमाने के अंदर ऐसा नहीं रहेगा कि मैं सिर्फ जावा करूं या मैं .NET करूं इवन जावा पीपल आर इंटरेक्टिंग विद द .NET एप्लीकेशंस .NET एप्लीकेशंस आर इंटरेक्टिंग विद द जावा एप्लीकेशंस एंड दिस माइंडसेट इज रियली मेकिंग यू कंफर्टेबल फॉर गोइंग फॉर दिस एरिया सो वेलकम रवि फॉर दिस सेशन अंकुर आर यू देयर राइट नाउ आई थिंक अंकुर माइट बी बिजी विद हिज ओन काइंड ऑफ क्लाइंट मीटिंग सबका 10 बजे का कॉल है सब उसके लिए तैयार हो रहे So thank you very much and tomorrow morning we will come back and in that particular program we will follow our command line tools for creating this small applications jahan pe class inheritance abstraction encapsulation polymorphism hum jaake apna e-commerce application project point of view leke karenge sab saath mein jaake practice karenge aaj ke liye maine practical nahi rakha tha because today is actually setting the guideline today's टाइम इज एक्चुअली सेटिंग द अप्रोच ये अप्रोच अगर दिमाग में बैठ जाए तो शायद कल से हम कोडिंग करते समय बहुत अच्छी तरह से एंजॉय करेंगे नोबडी विल बी बोर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ राइटिंग सिंपल लाइक अ क्लास सिंटैक्स बट दे विल ऑलवेज फाइंड द विजन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंकिंग अप्रोच ऑफ ई कॉमर्स एप्लीकेशन एंड दे विल अंडरस्टैंड कि मैं ये कोड क्यों लिख रहा हूँ उसके पीछे का रीजन क्या है दैट विल गेट अ वेरी गुड काइंड ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग ओके सो कैन वी स्टॉप टुडे हियर एट दिस मोमेंट This recorded session, I'll make it available just within 15-20 minutes. If you are new to these technologies, if you are new all those things, I would really suggest please watch this recorded video of today. आज का जो today का जो recorded session आप देखोगे ना, आप दो या तीन बार देखो अगर आप fresher हो. There are certain things you may not have come across, but at least get that words. करेक्ट नो? और फिर कल से coding हम पूरा C# का सीखने वाले. So newcomers need to develop the mindset of bird's eye view. Senior people need to understand the bird's eye view focus for your project how it goes to the granular level and how to really think this project and coding and C# syntax will help us for building such kind of applications I'm very happy that all of you join and we are keeping the journey it is just second day is going on that means 1.5 hour and 3 hours 100 hours minus 3 hours how many hours are left can you tell me 100 hours minus 3 hours how many hours left 97 hours left if in these 3 hours we learn a lot these things I think about how many things we are going to learn within remaining 97 hours gradually okay no it's a good journey it's a good thing let's keep ourselves tuned with that have a nice day and you are always I'm always available on my whatsapp you can always fire me questions on my whatsapp okay no if required we'll again get connected thank you and see you tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock I'm happy all of you here. Have a nice day. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. You can get me connected also at the back also. Yeah. Thanks. Soren, are you there right now? Priyadarshini, Swarali.
Yes, sir.
I just wanted to check. Who is this, Priyadarshini or Swarali?
Swarali.
Swarali. Okay. आजच्या सेशनच्या पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू काही काही गोष्टी कळल्यात काही गोष्टी नाही कळल्यात मला सांगू शकता?
हो सर, मला कळाले पण परत एकदा रिवाइंड करायला लागेल.
एक गोष्ट सोरेली मॅडम लक्षात ठेवा की आपल्याला कुठलीही गोष्ट लक्षात ठेवायची नाही. ओके, आपण आतापर्यंत जे काही शिकलो ते कसं आलंय, आपण प्रत्येक गोष्ट आहे ना लक्षात ठेवण्यासाठी करत होतो. आणि जेव्हा लक्षात ठेवायची जेव्हा प्रोसेस येते त्यावेळेस होतं काय की ते मेमोराईज करण्यासाठी एफर्ट्स घ्यावे लागतात आणि त्यावेळेस मग ते पटकन डोक्यात जात नाही. आता लक्ष असं, आता जस्ट थिंक लाईक आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू मेमोराईज, आय जस्ट वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टँड. आता जे आपण सेशन कव्हर केले तर भरपूर गोष्ट आपण असं सिक्वेन्सनी बोलत गेलो आहेत, भरपूर गोष्टीचं लिंक लागत गेली, तर हेच परत रेकॉर्डेड सेशन एकदा परत पाहिलं तर काही गोष्टींचा उलगडा होईल. ओके, त्यावेळेस मग तुम्हाला काहीतरी क्वेश्चन पडतील, त्याचे ते काही क्वेश्चनची उत्तर आपण उद्यापासून सगळे ते रिझॉल्व्ह करणार आहोत. पण आता आपल्या मनाला काहीतरी क्वेश्चन पडले पाहिजेत, आपल्या क्युरियस माइंडसेटला हे काय असतं, रवी सरांनी हा कुठला वर्ड वापरला, रवी सरांनी हे काय सांगितलं, है की नाही, हे कुठं असं नोट डाऊन जर करून जर ठेवला असं, हा वर्ड मी कधी ऐकला नव्हता, हा वर्ड काहीतरी लिहून ठेवा, कदाचित ह्या पुढच्या 97 आवर्स मध्ये कुठेतरी तो वर्ड आपण प्रॅक्टिकली इम्प्लिमेंट करणार आहोत. म्हणजे आज मी काहीतरी कुबेरनेटीज असं काहीतरी बोललो होतो, बरोबर, आज मी काहीतरी डेटा सेंटर असं काहीतरी बोललो होतो, आज मी काहीतरी क्लाउड ऍप असं काहीतरी बोललो होतो, आज मी माझ्या सेशन मध्ये असं काहीतरी कंटेनर नावाचा शब्द काहीतरी वापरला होता, बरोबर ना, मी आज माझ्या सेशन मध्ये काहीतरी प्लॅटफॉर्म असा काहीतरी शब्द वापरला होता. मग कदाचित हे वर्ड्स आपल्याला पूर्णपणे समजले नसतील कारण आपण आता जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस झाले सगळ्या टेक्नॉलॉजीला, है की नाही, पण हे वर्ड्स आपले उद्या आपल्या बरोबर दररोजचे राहणार आहेत. मग आजपासून काही गोष्टींची नवीन ओळख, तोंड ओळख झाली, उद्या ह्या तोंड ओळख झालेल्या गोष्टींची आपल्याला जास्त क्लॅरिटीनी समजण्याची म्हणजे आपलं पुढे हे होणार आहे. पण आतापासून तुम्ही असं लिस्ट डाऊन करत जावा, करेक्ट ना, तर शक्यतो जे कोणी सध्या हे सेशन अटेंड करतात त्यांना हा एक्सपिरियन्स नाही, तुमच्यासाठी हे सेशन आहे. जे लोक बाकीचे जॉईन होत आहेत दे आर ऑलरेडी वर्किंग अँड दे वॉन्टेड टू ऑल्सो गेट देअर बेसिक्स क्लिअर, समजलं का, बट देअर बेसिक्स दे वॉन्टेड टू क्लिअर बिकॉज समथिंग दे वॉन्टेड टू लॅक, they are lagging, that's why they're coming for this thing. But our session is for you people, you want to get that foundation strong, correct no, to aapko zyada dhyan mein rakhi ye pura focus karna hai, theek hai, to please watch this recorded video, okay, on WhatsApp I'm always available for answering your questions so that the second day session, the next day session will be much more interesting for you and you're always eagerly wait for getting connected for this further session. Okay, Swarali, Priyadarshini, अजिंक्य,
यस अंकल,
चालेल,
यस,
तर मी हे रेकॉर्डेड सेशन तुम्हाला शेअर करतोय आणि प्लीज तुमच्याकडे वेळ आहे, तुमच्याकडे वेळ आहे तर त्या वेळेचा वापर करून हे रिव्हिजन करा, हे समजून घ्यायचा प्रयत्न करा.
यस अंकल,
मला प्रश्न विचारा, बाकीचे लोक ऑलरेडी कंपनी मध्ये काम करतात, त्यांना जॉब ऑलरेडी मिळालेला आहे, दे आर ऑलरेडी सॅटिस्फाईड विथ देअर ऑल काइंड ऑफ थिंग, सो डेफिनेटली देअर इंटरेस्ट विल बी ओनली इन अंडरस्टँडिंग, युअर इंटरेस्ट इज मोर ऑन गेटिंग रेडी, तर तुमच्याकडून ते एफर्ट्स जास्त होतील पुढे हळूहळू. आता ते कसे घ्यायचे कसे करायचे ती माझी जबाबदारी आहे, पण तुम्ही फक्त या प्रोसेस मध्ये प्रॉपरली इन्वॉल्व व्हा, बस एवढीच माझी अपेक्षा
आहे.
ओके, चलो देन, सी यू, आय विल मेक दिस व्हिडिओ अवेलेबल टू यू, थँक यू,
थँक यू,
थँक यू, बाय,
हॅव अ गुड डे.